Now, as you can imagine, my job is to review productivity apps. It's the most unproductive job in the world, but one of the things that I'd have to do is come across a new and latest technology on the market. And it's quite a fun job for me, but an opportunity for you to work out whether an application is going to be one that you use in the future. Today, I'm going to review a software called Hoop and give you my insights into whether it could be the future of AI task management and unlock more productivity for you as you spend more time in meetings. So let's dive into Hoop in this review. Hello everyone, my name is Francesco D'Alessio. Welcome to the Toolfinder YouTube channel. If you're interested, you can subscribe down here, but you can also go over to toolfinder.co to explore more tools and reviews, as well as reviews and ratings if you're interested too. And thankfully today, we have a special offer on our new Bento methodology course, which helps to teach you about priority management and a system that's going to help you to do that in the long run. So you can find that linked below. There will be a discount to it to better help you to prioritize and not focus on tasks every single day. It's a system that I use and developed for you. So now we've got all that out of the way, let's dive into Hoop. Now, for those who don't know what Hoop is, it's an AI task management software that wants to help you to capture tasks and then prioritize them. And essentially what it does is help you to do that through meetings. So you can connect up with your Slack, you can connect up with Google Meet and Zoom, and basically just let the software do the work in the background. So you have your meeting, it extracts a task, and it helps you to prioritize it. Now, what I'm gonna do in this review, show you the main features, give you my pros and cons, and of course, mention the pricing as we begin, just to give you an idea if it's in your price bracket. And I'm gonna give you a full summary near the end of this video to see whether it's right for you. So this application got my interest mainly because of the concept of capture and prioritize. This concept is something that I really like. When combined with artificial intelligence, it could be really powerful. And the second thing that got me interested in this is that it's the former VP and head of marketing at Trello. And I naturally followed Stella, and she is one of the co-founders of Hoop. So I naturally was very interested when this company came up because I liked some of her concepts around to-do list management. So naturally, it was an interest as part of that. So this application's in beta, so it's early days, but let me take you through the main features and then into the pricing. So the main features of this application is that once you plug it in with Slack, Google Meet, and Zoom, it'll essentially track stuff in the background for you. For example, I spent a 2-hour meeting midweek and it extracted all of the tasks from the transcript and turned them into actionable items in the capture area. This is a column that's dedicated in the Hoop dashboard for you to see the tasks and the context correlated to the transcript to help you to work out the task that's at hand. It'll automatically use AI to tag the importance of items based on the context of the transcript, which is incredibly helpful. Now, I also connected it with my Slack and it saved a few items from conversations that I was having across the week with people. I also was able to use the forwarding email feature to send in a task that allowed to summarize that task and bring it into the system, which can be provided to you from day one. I didn't get to use the Zoom integration, but I'm sure it works in the same exact way as the Google Meet does too. So basically from here, you can add additional columns, move tasks into them, and naturally you can move stuff around relevant, adding due dates, labels, and more to all of the different tasks that you have, which is incredibly helpful for narrowing down your options as you're working across a day. Now, one of the things that was particularly impressive was the prioritize feature or focus feature that sits at the top of the bar. Now, I thought this would be a toggle that just allow you to filter down your labels, which is something that's typically available in a lot of applications. But what it did was very smart. You typed in a prompt that is AI generated, of course, like launching the book project, and essentially it narrows down all of the tasks on your list to focus in on those tasks that made that needle move towards the book project, which is incredibly helpful and really potent in terms of removing all that distraction, having you focus on that, which I thought was a very novel feature and something I haven't seen in task management. So when it comes to the pricing, this one is a little bit pricey. It's $35 per month, which is incredibly a lot, but for busy professionals that spend a lot of time in meetings, I can see this being something they'd be willing to invest in because a lot of these people are moving towards AI note-taking softwares or tools like that. But this sort of cuts the noise of notes and actually just goes straight to the task and the prioritization, which is something that I believe is a lot better in the future. But $35, I think, is a little bit steep. I would be open at the current rate to be paying around $20 to $25 if I was looking at this and I had lots of meetings, because it can take the weight out of them but I don't believe it's worth $35. So when you look at the pros of this application, I was very impressed with the capture function just because it had an area where it brought in all the tasks that was very good. That worked very well. I have one quirk about it that I wasn't too impressed with, but largely the concept of capture in the background is something that I believe is the future of productivity. Administration of tasks seems to be archaic when we look at it in the future. I think 3 to 5 years, we'll look back and go, that wasn't true productivity, that was administration on top of productivity. And us doing that was naturally a negative. I was also very impressed with the focus feature. Imagine if other task management apps decided to introduce an innovation like this, it would be very cool and allow you to have a narrowed choice. And I believe that in itself is the first time I've seen that, but actually a massive innovation and uses artificial intelligence very well. So when looking at the cons of this application, I actually found one quirk that I didn't like about it. So when I used the Google Meet transcript function where I just had my meeting, I had to wait about 30 to 45 minutes for it to land all the tasks in my AI capture area. Now, I found this to be a little bit, I guess, not so good. I actually spoke to the team about this and they said this was an intentional feature to actually slow the progress because you might have back-to-back meetings and those tasks aren't necessarily being pulled. But I can imagine it's because of the speed of the AI. Being able to extract all the tasks from the transcript probably does take a little bit of time in terms of computing power. So I can imagine that taking a little bit of time. But what if you were to review something or all of your tasks for the week right after you've had 5 meetings in a row and you had to wait another 30 minutes for those to all import? Now, maybe this was a case by case basis, but the team seemed to make me aware this was actually intentional. Now, of course, this is a beta. So of course, that's something to know, but just something that I found to be not as impressive, especially when it comes to seeing or going into the review process right after a meeting. So my overall review on Hoop is it's a promising concept. The concept of administration will be gone and apps like this will take place. And I believe that Hoop is probably one of the best representations that I've seen of AI task management for this context. It beat the AI note-taking in my experience, because unless you're looking to contextualize everything that you do or maybe make notes and pass them on to people, this actually goes to the bones of what you're doing and extract the important stuff. The design and the AI focus of the focus ability was particularly impressive. So I believe this has got an incredibly promising future. My worries are that the pricing is too high and that the connectors are not as good value for money at the current time. I believe having 5 to 10 connectors in terms of software that you're bringing in, they do have a Zapier integration which you can connect, but for the regular people, it might just be worth having the integration direct. But the fact that they don't have a vast amount of connectors is something that I wasn't as impressed with. So they do have a promising future and it is a promising application, just not at this current point in time. It's still a beta. Anyway, folks, hopefully you found this review of Hoop interesting and you found this valuable as a general overview of Hoop and how hopefully my opinions were helpful for you in making a decision. So thank you very much. I look forward to helping you with finding a tool. Jump over to toolfinder.co if you're interested and let's explore more resources together. So thank you very much and make sure to subscribe. I'll see you all very soon. Cheerio.